Welcome to This Week in the Index. I'm your host, Grayson Brulte. Overall, it was the second down week in the markets in a row. For the week of August 7th, the road to Autonomy Index declined 2%. The S&P 500 declined 2.6%. The NASDAQ 100 declined 1.9%. The road to Autonomy Index outperformed the S&P 500 by 0.6%. The road to Autonomy Index underperformed the NASDAQ 100 by 0.1%. The top performing stocks in the Road to Autonomy Index this week were Caterpillar, which returned 3.18%, AutoNation, which returned 2.58%, Berkshire Hathaway, which returned 2.39%. While these stocks perform well, they are just three of the 38 publicly traded companies that are components of the Road to Autonomy Index. News and opinion drives the market, and this week in autonomy, there were some developments. This week, I had the honor of attending the 2023 J.P. Morgan Autos Conference. The investor sentiment coming out of the conference is that autonomy is investable. While autonomy is investable, the companies that are developing the technology are taking differentiated approaches. At the conference, Navin Kumar, Chief Financial Officer at Ford Pro, spoke at length about Ford's partial autonomy strategy and the revenue this will approach and will unlock for Ford Pro. After disbanding Argo AI in October of 2022, Ford has been focused on developing SAE Level 2 autonomy for highway driving. Ford CEO Jim Farley, currently on a road trip across America in a Ford F-150 Lightning, has been beta testing the latest version of Blue Cruise and documented its progress on Twitter, now known as X. Is this the right approach for Ford? Only time will tell if this is the right approach. But what we know is that Ford, under Jim Farley, is focused on developing a services business, which Blue Cruise will be a part of. Mr. Farley is predicting that Ford's services business will grow 1,000% over the next few years. Today, Ford has nearly 500,000 software subscribers, with most of the subscribers being Ford Pro customers. Ford sees the potential to unlock nearly $2,000 of annual software subscription revenue from solutions including Productivity Suite, Safety and Security, Managed Charging, and Partial Autonomy. Then when you factor in non-software solutions connected commercial insurance, the potential revenue forecast increases to $4,000 to $5,000 per vehicle annually. Over a three-year lease, there's a potential for Ford to generate $12,000 to $15,000 in services revenue. Ford services generates gross margins above 50% compared to the 8.3% margin before interest and taxes that Ford had in this year's first half. Are services the key to unlocking value in Ford stock? We will soon find out. Then there is GM, a Road to Autonomy Index component company, which is taking a different approach than Ford to autonomy. GM is all in on full autonomy, with their Cruise division expanding at a significant pace. Cruise is currently driving more than 1 million driverless miles a month. That number, it's only expected to increase as Cruise expands to more cities and they begin operating 24/7 in San Francisco. At the J.P. Morgan Autos Conference, Paul Jacobson, Chief Financial Officer of GM, presented and he spoke about Cruise and scaling its operations. As part of the Q&A session, I asked Mr. Jacobson how Cruise was managing their rapid expansion, and the answer in a nutshell was Mr. Gil West. Mr. Gil West is the former COO of Delta and now COO of Cruise. Mr. West, who's been on the Road to Autonomy podcast and will be on an upcoming episode, is managing the scaling of Cruise by focusing on reliability, the optimization of resources, fleet management and maintenance, and the overall customer experience. Is Mr. West and his team one of the keys to Cruise's success? We would argue and say yes, as Mr. West is using his vast knowledge of operating large, complex transportation businesses with challenges such as weather and ground operations. To scale an autonomous vehicle company, you need the right executive bench with the right experience. This is where Cruise is thriving and others are floundering. Another participant at the J.P. Morgan Autos Conference was James Reed, COO of Kodiak. Mr. Reed is the former CEO of USA Trucks, who successfully sold the company to D.B. Schneider in September of 2022. By way of background, Mr. Reed has a finance background, and it showed when he presented at the J.P. Morgan Conference. Mr. Reed gave a clear and concise overview of the Kodiak business and where the company is heading, complete with financial projections. The financial projections shared were impressive, and it puts Kodiak, along with the rest of the autonomous trucking industry, on the road to becoming a very, very big business. Mr. Reed and Mr. West have a lot in common. Both gentlemen have run large transportation businesses, and both are now currently at autonomy startups as COOs. Mr. West with Kyle Vogt, founder and CEO of Cruise, and Mr. Reed with Don Burnett, founder and CEO of Kodiak. Is one of the keys to success of running an autonomous vehicle company and scaling it having a strong number two? Based on the data and what we are seeing from Cruise and Kodiak in the market, one can make that compelling argument. Another company presented that tends to fly below the radar but is highly successful is Gatik. Gatik, led by co-founder and CEO Gaham Narang, is building a real business focused on the middle mile. The middle mile in autonomy, it's niche. And Gatik really has no competitors. And Gatik scaling with customers such as Walmart and Kroger. The future for Gatik is extremely bright. As the company gains market share from traditional delivery companies, you'll want to keep an eye on Gatik as they grow. There's big things coming there. Another thing to keep your eye on is the city of San Francisco. The city is posturing to sue the California Public Utilities Commission after the commission ruled 3-1 on Thursday, August 10th, to allow Waymo and Cruise to offer 24/7 paid taxi service in San Francisco. Aaron Peskin, president of the San Francisco Board of Supervisors, told the Washington Post that he and Mayor London Breed and the members of the city's transportation agencies plan to meet after the vote to, quote-unquote, discuss next steps. Mr. Peskin told the Washington Post that the city would likely file for a rehearing, which would be a precursor to litigation against the commission. Why take this step when autonomous vehicles in San Francisco are only going to help the city's economy? The ruling was favorable for the residents of San Francisco, visitors to San Francisco, the San Francisco economy, and the entire autonomous vehicle industry. Next up, AB 316. Will California side up with the Teamsters and effectively ban autonomous trucks in the state? Or will the state side with progress, lowering inflation and creating jobs? Autonomy is good for the economy. Autonomy is coming. Autonomous vehicles and autonomous trucks will help to usher in the autonomy economy. Today, we are merely at the starting line for what is to come with autonomy and its economic impact. In the future, autonomy will be one of the world's largest industries in the world. Autonomy is a business, and there is an index to track its performance. The autonomy economy is coming. Follow the Road to Autonomy Index, ticker autonomy, on your favorite finance app. Again, the ticker is autonomy, AUTONOMY. Be sure to join us again next Sunday for the latest installment of the Road to Autonomy's This Week in the Index. The future is bright. The future is autonomous. The future is differentiating autonomy business models.